If you've ever watched like a movie or a TV show that depicts the United States Army, there's possibly a lot of things that you see that make it look really awesome, but there's other things that you don't often see, right? There's things that just don't make sense probably for the story, and maybe if that's all you see is these movies, these TV shows depicting the United States Army, maybe you're missing certain things that are the reality of the Army. Now, I'm not saying these things should be in the movies or TV shows because probably wouldn't make that great of a story, possibly, but I want to make sure that you know about some of the things that probably movies and TV leave out about being in the Army. Now, this video is sponsored by Raycon, a little bit more on them, but I got a few things that I want to talk about in this video to let you know what movies and TV leave out from being in the Army. One of those would probably be the amount of cleaning that you do and other things that are kind of related to that. Obviously, like I said, you don't really want to show that. I mean, there might be moments here and there where you do see, you know, soldiers or military personnel in TV and movies doing some cleanup stuff, but it actually happens probably a little bit more than what you see in the movies. But again, it would be pretty boring if they probably did show it to the extent that you actually do it. Because sure, you might see some things where, you know, some soldiers are cleaning the bathroom, maybe they're mopping, they're doing some things sometimes in movies, but there's more that goes beyond that. There's things, what we call in the Army, police call. I've actually done a video before talking about like some acronyms or some phrases and stuff like that that maybe normal people don't know, and police call was one of them that people didn't get correctly because it has nothing to do with the police or anything. It's picking up trash, and that happens a lot. You're standing around and stuff like that, they'll be like, hey, can we get a couple people to go do a police call around the building? And that means you're gonna go around the building looking for trash, picking up anything, picking weeds, right? That's another one you'll kind of do, and just looking for anything that just doesn't belong. But even outside of just trash, I mean, mowing lawns is a big one. You'll have all sorts of duties to, you know, go and clean different things to, you know, they have other things like maybe, you know, picking up trash along the side of the road where you have like these trucks that'll kind of fall along with you and you got to put stuff in bags and you got to do that. Essentially, this is what's called Red Cycle. They usually have it where periodically during certain times of like the year, different units kind of cycle through Red Cycle. And that means that they're going to be doing different tasks like this, like maybe mowing lawns, picking up trash and other things that need to be done around the area. So there is a lot of cleaning that has to be done because there also isn't like janitors in the Army. Essentially, every soldier could possibly be a janitor. So if the bathrooms need to be cleaned in the building that you work out of, if you have to, you know, clean the floors, the motor pool, that's all done by soldiers. There's no, you know, civilians that come and do that stuff typically, unless certain higher levels might have it, like a battalion or brigade, maybe. They have like a contract to do that. But for the most part, it's usually soldiers that are the ones having to mop the floors, sweep up, clean the windows, do all that stuff. So there's a lot of cleaning that goes on in the military that you don't often usually see that stuff, you know, when you're watching these TV shows or movies. Now, this video is sponsored by the Raycon Everyday Earbuds. These things have amazing sound quality, and if you act now, they got big savings coming up for Black Friday and Cyber Monday, because when you visit buyraycon.com/chaosarmy, you're gonna get up to 30% off site-wide. Now, the price point is great, and some people worry, does that mean that they're not gonna have very good sound quality? And no, even though the competitors have a much higher price point type of thing than Raycon's Everyday Earbuds, these things sound amazing. I love listening to these things. One of the amazing things I think you get out of these things is you actually get pretty good bass out of earbuds, and you wouldn't expect to get that out of earbuds. That is one of my favorite things about the Raycon Everyday Earbuds, but I also like to use them even just with one. I'll pop one into one ear, I'll have it connected to my phone, I'll sit there and surf through social media, watch some videos, and still have the other ear open to be able to like listen to Mrs. Chaos or watch TV or talk to other people in the room. It works great, even just one earbud in has still really good quality. But you know, if you're doing a workout, you're exercising or whatever, you rock both of them inside of both ears, great noise cancellation. They got active noise cancellation. You can tap for different features to be able to change it so you have like adaptive mode and you can be able to hear your music and still hear people around you. And they have a really good fit too. I definitely don't worry about them falling out if I'm running on like on a treadmill or doing other exercises because they fit so great. Now I have a great case that they go inside of. I got the black pair here, but they come in multiple different colors. And with the charging case, you can also do wireless charging, or you have a USB-C port on the bottom to be able to charge it that way. And it has fast charging capabilities because With it fully charged, you can get up to 32 hours, but if you run a little bit of low on battery space and you gotta hurry up and charge it in a hurry, well, just simply 10 minutes of charging can give you an hour and a half of battery life. So don't miss out on the great Black Friday and Cyber Monday deals, so make sure you head over to buyraycon.com/chaosarmy so you can get up to 30% off site-wide. I'll have a link down in the description box down below, as well as a pinned comment. Go check these out. These things are pretty awesome. There's also a lot of admin things that are kind of going on too that you don't see in movies, again, because it'd probably be pretty boring, but there's a lot of admin stuff that goes on. A lot of this required training that soldiers have to do, like online. For example, any of my veteran viewers out there, people that are currently in the Army, who's this guy? Let me know down in the comment section down below. But there's all sorts of online training that soldiers have to do. They have to do this yearly. They have to do it every 6 months. And, you know, somebody at their unit is tracking, hey, have you done the anti-terrorism class? Have you done this phishing class? You know, it's not phishing. It's different kind of fishing, but there's all sorts of these classes that soldiers have to do periodically, and there's somebody that has to track that stuff and let people know if somebody is not within compliance of doing this, and then they have to go and, you know, maybe go to the library, maybe go use the Nipper computer, which is like an internet computer, maybe in one of the offices, or maybe they just have them go home to go work on it and bring in the certificate to show that they've completed the course. That's one of like the big ones, is there's always these periodic training you have to do, but there's other things outside of just these periodic trainings you have to do. There's just a lot of other admin stuff. There's a lot of things like what's known as, I think they changed the name, but it was called SRP. But you have to kind of, you know, go through these stations and kind of make sure you're up to date on things and, you know, making sure you're current on like vaccinations and eye tests and all sorts of stuff. And, you know, there's a lot of admin things that go along with that. And all sorts of things, right? But there's a lot of things that, you know, they're not going to show in TV and movies, but there's a lot of admin stuff that you still have to do when you're in the Army. Here's a fun one. How about all the dumb stuff that soldiers do? Now, sure, you might have some of that stuff, like maybe like in a comedy show or a comedy movie, but for the most part, you know, most Army movies are kind of like glorifying all the cool stuff that is happening. Maybe it's the battle, maybe it's missions or whatever kind of a thing, but trust me, there's a lot of dumb stuff that soldiers do. A lot of it kind of comes from you get bored, right? You're sitting around in the motor pool, you're out in the field, and you're not always just go, go, go. I mean, there's moments where it can be like that sometimes, sure, but there's also a lot of times where it's not, where it's just dead. You know, there's a big expression that you'll hear soldiers talk about the whole hurry up and wait, and, you know, a lot of just kind of sitting around doing nothing type of thing, and that usually causes soldiers to get kind of bored and start doing some kind of dumb stuff. I'll give you some examples. I remember this one soldier that they got dared to drink chew spit, right? If you're not familiar, right? People that chew tobacco, they spit into a bottle type of thing. And they gathered up a bunch of chew spit, pretty gross, disgusting. And they all pitched in, I think about 50 to 100 bucks, I forget how much it was, and dared this one soldier to drink it. And he drank it. I think he threw up a little bit later and stuff like that, but nonetheless, he did it, and it's a pretty dumb thing, but that's part of what soldiers kind of do when they get bored. Another fun one is the milk challenge. I'm sure civilians do this too, possibly, maybe not as often as soldiers do, but there's this milk challenge of trying to drink a gallon of milk within a certain time frame, and spoiler alert, it doesn't work because your stomach can't like process the dairy fast enough, so you're gonna end up throwing up. But nonetheless, there's some soldier out there usually is like, I can do that, I bet you I could do that. And I've seen it multiple times, and they don't do it. They fail. They end up vomiting horribly, like all over the place. I'm sure some of my veterans out there have some great, funny, hilarious stories of moments like this where soldiers get bored, soldiers be soldiers, and to kill the time, they do some dumb stuff. And I'd love to hear about that maybe down in the comment section down below. What are some of the dumb things you've seen soldiers do when boredom gets the best of us? Now, one last one, and that is that you often see, I think I was talking about this earlier, actually, but you often see, like, in movies and TV shows where it looks like soldiers are awesome. They're so amazing, right? They do all this cool stuff. They're badasses. They can do all these cool, neat things and everything. Well, it's not always like that. Spoiler, you know, you don't just graduate basic training and become a badass. You know, it takes training. It takes time. So one of the things you don't usually see in movies is soldiers just sucking at things. You're going to have some soldiers, just like anything, they're not very good at their job. They're not very good at just doing certain things. You know, I see that sometimes, sadly, with my job, right? I teach soldiers how to use the JVCP system and navigation system, and not every single soldier that I see is great on the system. There's some soldiers that struggle really hard with comprehending the knowledge and being able to do the tasks they have to do to be able to complete the course. And that is the same kind of thing with a lot of things. You'll have soldiers that suck at weapons qualification. It takes them multiple times to pass that weapons qualification. Maybe they suck really bad at, you know, the ACFT, the Army Combat Fitness Test, and, you know, they have to go on remedial PT to be able to get back into good shape so that they hopefully can pass it, and maybe that takes them multiple times. But these aren't things you usually see. You know, you don't want to show, you know, the soldiers failing at things, but it happens, right? And so they just kind of, you know, focus, of course, you know, to make the movie great, make the TV show fun, on the cool stuff that they're doing, the amazing things they're doing and succeeding. Because, yeah, it'd be a weird movie probably if you're showing like, oh, cool, this soldier did awesome, but hey, Joe Snuffy over here, he failed his ACFT, he failed his fitness test. All right, moving on back to this Rambo dude over here. But it happens, right? It comes from experience, right? Eventually, soldiers hopefully gain experience and overcome some of this stuff. But especially like when you're a new, brand new soldier, you're probably going to suck for a while until you kind of get the flow of things. Maybe you excel at certain things because maybe you're just cool like that. I don't know. But there are definitely things that take practice, that take, you know, doing it and training over and over again to get good at it, to be at that level that maybe you see these awesome individuals in movies. But for the most part, you know, not everyone's just going to be badass out the gate. They're going to suck at some things, probably fail at some things for a little while, and then eventually, hopefully, you know, get good at it, hopefully. There are probably like a bunch of other things too that, you know, movies leave out and TV shows leave out for good reasons. But if you can think of something that you know that, like, I know that soldiers do this or do that, right? Especially like my veteran viewers out there, whatever. Comment down in the comment section down below. Let me know what else does TV shows and movies leave out. Maybe for good reasons, maybe for bad reasons. Maybe they should put some of these things in movies or TV shows to let everybody know that, you know, these things happen. But nonetheless, leave a comment down in the comment section down below. If you don't know of anything that maybe is left out of movies or TV shows, I would like to hear from you. What is your favorite military movie, right? Maybe drop that down in the comment section down below. What is your favorite military movie? For me, it'd be hard to narrow down like one probably favorite military movie. I think it was called The Castle. That was a pretty cool one with these soldiers in Iraq. Outpost was a really good movie, especially with it being such a true story type of thing. But sadly, maybe up there, my favorite one is probably a comedy, and it's probably In the Army Now. You know, that Pauly Shore movie is great. It's fun. But hey, don't end your experience with watching videos now. I got another video right here that you should probably check out. Make sure you subscribe to the channel. Make sure you're hitting that thumbs up. Thanks for hanging out. Thanks for watching. I'm Christopher Chaos. I'll see you next time. See ya.